A sports stadium has an electronic counter that counts each person that enters the stadium. The count is stored as binary in a 16-bit register. A denary value of the count is displayed on a screen at the entrance. Sensors are used at the entrance to count the number of people entering the stadium. Identify two sensors that could be used to count the number of people entering the stadium. So this type of question might seem very simple. However, in the exam, you may get a blank and you may forget the different types of sensors. If this happens, you always want to use the information that's been given to you. And in this case, you can actually visualize the system that's being used. In this question, they've told us that people are entering a stadium. So they must be passing through a door or a gateway of sorts. Let's try and visualize what that might look like. We want to count them at a specific entrance that everyone is going to go through. There are a number of ways we can implement this sort of detection. The first way is that we could be using a motion detector in the top corner of the entrance that would then detect any movements going through the door. So the first answer here would be a motion sensor. Another method we could use would be an underground pressure sensor. When someone steps on the sensor, it would activate and it would increment the count. Both of these methods have their pros and cons. One may be more accurate than the other. Fortunately, this question doesn't ask us to compare the different methods. It just asks us to identify the two sensors. So the second answer here would be a pressure sensor. Bear in mind here, we're speaking about sensors. So we can't answer something like a digital camera or a web camera. That could use artificial intelligence to track how many people are going through the door. The digital camera in that case would be an input device and not necessarily a sensor. The next question says tick one box to show if a sensor is an example of an input device, storage device, or an output device. It can't be an output device because output devices display data to the user. It can't be a storage device. Since we can't store values within our sensor, we can send data from the sensor to a microprocessor, but we can't store specific values within our sensor. So for that reason, it must be an input device. And there we go. That question is complete.